The book review is a form of literary criticism. If you are a student of literature, you must learn how to write a book review and write a good book review at that. If you join the academic profession, if you become a teacher, you will be expected to write book reviews at frequent intervals. Let me warn you that writing a book review is not, certainly not, the easiest thing in the world. It demands time, effort, patience, and skill. Today we shall discuss some of the important aspects of the process of writing a book review. One way of opening the review is by writing about the appearance of the book. How does the book look like? What is the nature of the cover? Is it attractive or is it dull? How big is the book? What kind of paper has gone into the production of the book? What is the font used? What is the font size? On the whole, how does the book strike you? What is the price of the book? After all, it is the appearance of the book that the reader comes to grips with first. And it is the appearance of the book that you came to grips with first. However, please do not spend too much time, too much space on this part of the review, because ultimately you are a reviewer. You are a reviewer of the book. You are not a reviewer of the dust jacket. Next, you can focus attention on the title of the book. What do you feel about the title of the book? Is it justifiable? Does the title of the book bring the reader to the book? Is it a catchy title? Could there have been a better title? To what extent can you relate the title of the book to the body of the book? How far is the title appropriate for the contents of the book? Do you think that the writer has chosen the title of his book rather carelessly? What are the interpretations possible for the title of the book? Can the title of the book be read, be interpreted in more than one way? And are all the ways in which it can be interpreted appropriate for the contents of the book? Now you can try to give the reader a sort of introduction to the book. Try to give the reader an understanding of the nature of the book. Here you can provide a brief summary of the book. If the book is a novel, a work of fiction, you can try to give a brief overview of the plot of the book, plot of the novel. If the book is a work of non-fiction, you can try to identify the fundamental thesis of the book. The idea is that with a few deft strokes, you should give a clear picture of what the book is all about. The reader should get a clear idea of what the book is all about. If the book is a collection of poems, what are the important themes dealt with by the poet? What are the stylistic devices used by the poet? How far does the poet succeed in his mission? Now you can try to identify the strengths of the book. What, in your opinion, makes the book what it is. What are the positive things you can say about the book? In what way is the book different from other books of the same category? I think that here you can quote a couple of passages, appropriate passages from the book under review. This is particularly so when the book being reviewed is a collection of poems. There is no better way to give the reader a flavor of the dish that is the book than by quoting from the book. Make it a point to keep the quotations short rather than long, and make it a point to use quotations which are appropriate. This is the place to locate the weaknesses of the book. In what way is the book a not so good book? Or what are the ways in which the writer can make the book a better book? What are the important weaknesses of the book? How could the writer have overcome the weaknesses? You can now give an overall assessment of the book. Do you consider the book a success? If so, why? Or a failure? Or not a success? If not, why not? What should the writer have done to make the book a success if the book is not deemed to be a success right now? Please try to be balanced when you write such things, when you try to write such things. Of course, every book review is the result of a personal interaction between the reviewer and the book. And every book review is ultimately a personal statement. But that does not absolve the reviewer from the responsibility of being balanced. Try to avoid writing one-sided reviews. Try to see things from all perspectives. Your perspective need not be the sole perspective in this world. Is there anything striking about the book? Anything extraordinary? Anything remarkable which you want to bring to the notice of the reader? This is the time to do that. There is no rigid structure for a review. The structure of a review is decided by the reviewer himself. The only question is whether the review succeeds in giving the reader a flavor of the dish. If it succeeds in giving the reader a flavor of the dish, it is a successful review. If not, it is a failure.